Welcome to Chaos and Cryptography. Here is another interesting video on Zaslavsky chaotic map. We have already seen a short video on how to generate chaotic values with this map, the link of which is given in the description box below. In this video, we'll see four pseudo random number generators with this map. Before going into the coding, we'll be seeing a short description of the Zaslavsky chaotic map. This map is a two-dimensional chaotic map which was introduced by George M. Zaslavsky in the year 1978. It is a typical example of discrete-time dynamical system. It is proved to be highly sensitive to its initial conditions. Owing to its sensitiveness, it has large applications in many cryptographic systems and other applications which require pseudo-randomness. Since it is a discrete-time system, the chaotic values are generated using iterative method, which is shown as given here. Another important point to be remembered in this map is that it has four control parameters, R, V, E, and U, where U is evaluated using E and R. Since it has four control parameters, it has large key space, and therefore a key generated using Zaslavsky chaotic map can highly withstand brute force attack. Coming to the coding, first we'll initialize the values of x and y, followed by the initialization of the control parameter values. For better understanding of these pseudo-random number generators, we'll generate only one value, and therefore size is initialized to 1. The function is called and the corresponding arguments are passed here. Coming to the function, as described below, we've already seen how to generate the chaotic values in the previous video, which is done using the iterative method. And therefore, x1 and y1 has the chaotic values of the Zaslavsky map. For better understanding, we'll see the output. Here we have x and y, which are the two-dimensional values of this map. The first method is generating the pseudo-random number, which is of the decimal format. This is done by extracting a particular value from x1 or y1. Here I am discarding the first four digits and extracting the remaining part of the decimal number. This is flexible and can be changed according to your needs. If you want to change different part of the extraction, then you have to change this factor accordingly. The second method generates pseudo-random numbers of the integer form. These set of numbers are going to be within the range 0 to 255. This is the example generated here. PNR2 is generated using method 2, and which is value 190. This value is within the range 0 to 255. This can be generated using this formula. And the most important thing is by using mod 256. Therefore, it will bring all the values within the range 0 to 255. An important application of this pseudorandom generator is image encryption, where each pixel value can be XORed with a pseudorandom number. Since the pixel value is within the range 0 to 255, we need to have pseudorandom numbers within the same range, and therefore method 2 can be used for this purpose. Method 3 is similar to method 2, which also generates pseudorandom numbers within a particular range of value. It also generates integer sets of numbers. Here, I have used mod 1024. Say 1024 is the length of the image, and therefore I have set of values within the range 0 to 1023. This can be used as indices, which can be used for shuffling the pixel values in an image encryption process. The formula used here in the method 2 and method 3, where I have used power 2,35 and power 2,20, are flexible and can be changed according to your applications. The pseudorandom number generated using method 3 is given here, 446. This may be the indice which will be used for a shuffling purpose. Method 4. This generates pseudorandom number in the binary form. There are many applications which require pseudorandom number in zeros and ones. For those cases, method 4 can be used. If we need to generate pseudorandom number in binary form, then please follow the following steps. First, generate chaotic values using the Zaslavsky chaotic map using this function. The second step is to convert the decimal numbers into integers using method 2 or method 3. Once we have the numbers in the integer format, the third step is to convert the integer number into binary form using method 4. And therefore, we have the pseudorandom numbers in the binary form. I like to stress one important point. All the formulas here are very much flexible and can be definitely changed according to your needs and applications. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more videos on chaos and cryptography.